Our major stance for our work is that we view the design as an operating point in a multidimensional design space. And there are trade-offs when you choose a specific operating point. In particular, these trade-offs can either be explicit. That means the designer is aware of all critical factors when we are choosing the operating point in a multidimensional design space. Or they can be implicit. Another fundamental view we bring to the table is that we separate functions from function carriers. So a function here is some capability that a system must be able to carry out. A function is, in other words, an abstraction. It does not refer to implemented functionality. A function carrier, sometimes referred to as a solution or solution principle, is an implementation of a function. A functional architecture of a system is an arrangement of functions that can subsequently be translated into a detailed technical description of function carriers. Our paper uses function structures coupled with envelope analysis to study the efficacy of word prediction. We are using envelope analysis in this paper. The idea is that we will extract design parameters from the functional description of the system and simulate potential performance by investigating a range of design parameter choices. Importantly, this analysis is carried out at the functional level. Having identified a functional model, it is possible to parameterize the model. There are fundamentally two classes of parameters, controllable parameters and uncontrollable parameters. Controllable parameters are parameters the designer can control explicitly. They allow optimization towards design objectives. Uncontrollable parameters govern function execution, but they cannot be explicitly set by the designer. They allow sensitivity analysis of the design. We revisit the function structure I introduced earlier in this talk. So this is the overall function predict word. It consists of three key functions: type key, predict word, and select word prediction. We can parameterize this function structure as follows. We have two input signals and they can be parameterized into tkey and treact, where tkey is the time it takes the user to hit a key. Treact is the time it takes a user to react to a word prediction suggestion. A latent set of parameters, strategy, generates process interaction between the design parameters. Lmin means restrict word prediction usage to words of a minimum length. Klook means type k keys and then look. Pmax means only attempt to check word predictions up to pmax keystrokes per word. Note that all of these parameters are in fact uncontrollable by the designer. We implement a simulator, which is depicted in the following flowchart. For details, please see the paper. This analysis allows us to understand the effect of word prediction in a different way than carrying out direct control experiments. For instance, we find that performance is strongly tied to the choice of typing strategy. The black dotted line here is the zero crossing, and it marks the boundary between performance gain and loss due to word predictions. Any strategy that looks at word predictions without typing at least one letter is shown to slow the user down. Performance gains are only realized if the user types at least the first two letters of each word before looking at predictions. The reliability of predictions increases with the number of letters typed. A net entry rate from word predictions can range from -8.8 word per minute to +2.9 word per minute solely as the result of the choice of typing strategy the user is using. In summary, designing HCI systems is hard. Designing intelligent interactive systems is even harder as AI-infused systems introduce more uncertainty. Function structure design allows designers to abstract a design as essential functions and flow of signals between these functions. These function structures can then be parameterized and analyzed using envelope analysis. This allows the designer to study the emergent qualities of joint human-computer system. We have used this proposed method to better understand the nuances of word prediction, and we believe these nuances cannot be discovered using traditional HCI methods such as controlled experimentation. For further results and a discussion of how this method can be used in tandem with existing design practice, please read the full paper.